Oh, here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Edgar Allan Poe was a distant cousin of Larkin Poe, who was actually our
great-great-great-great-grandfather.
We wanted to have a name that had familial significance since we are taking a lot of those stories. And Larkin Poe was a very interesting character in our area, and plus he has a really cool name, so.
I would be really curious to know what he thought of his great-great-great-great-granddaughters running around the world with his name on t-shirts.
Hear me that I've been lying for this too long. Hear me that I've been looking at you all wrong.
I think the weirdest part about being sisters is that I can look at her and know exactly what she's thinking. I had a really bad stutter as a kid, and so Megan, for all practical purposes, was my translator to the world. It created some really helpful communication skills, but some very dysfunctional ones as well.
We really know how to push each other's buttons. We'll just leave it at that.
We haven't spent more than 2 weeks apart from each other in our entire lives, which kind of is mind-boggling.
There's so much about music that's not verbal, and we know exactly what we want to do with the music. We don't even have to say. And in that way, it makes creating music and playing music together very easy.
When your mouth moves, look at me if I don't want to. What I saw in you, I can't.
People have had a hard time categorizing us because they just don't quite know what it is.
And we like to consider ourselves the definition swampadelic. It's like evocative of, you know, our southern roots.
It's very influenced by our area. We are from the South. Mm-hmm. We're deep in that culture.
We've really gone out of our way to do some research about our family, to hear stories of what it was like growing up, and to try and carry on that tradition in a way, or at least keep their stories alive. We have a history of very dark and tortured people in our family, people who were very, very intelligent, but stuck in a grinding poverty. And the fact that those sort of experiences are, to a certain degree, still going on is a great place from which to write songs.
A trick of an eye, but I saw you. I can't recall. I had an absolute sight.
I think it can be the most beautiful and painful thing that we do is songwriting. Good songwriting is about vulnerability. It's easy to write a song, but to write an honest song, that's the constant struggle. The paper's being suspended in the air. It's your song being suspended in the mind of someone else, and that is truly powerful.